media matter.
Really? So right here on my arm, I have two bracelets. Now I have three kids, 6, 8, and 12. And my 12-year-old, two times since she's been 10, has started her entrepreneurial journey. She got out her rainbow loom, she's picked cool colors, she's even tried to do some that are Clemson colors and some that are Carolina colors. She's thought about people that would maybe be interested in buying her bracelets. She found someone she knows who does social media pretty well, who fixed her up this really great Facebook page. I got a cute graphic, made her look pretty professional. And she, the page is there, and you know, she's 12. So she goes back to being a kid in the summer, enjoying the life, and she comes back to me about a month later, and she's like, "Hey mom, do I have anybody else who wants to buy a bracelet?" And I say, "When was the last time you've been to your Facebook page?" She said, "Oh, around 3, 4 weeks ago when we made the page." And I said, "So let me get this straight. You took the time and the effort to come up with this business. You have actually a great product that could serve a certain target market. But you, for the last 4 weeks, have told no one except for me and your father and your two siblings and your grandparents, who really didn't necessarily need a bracelet. But you are sitting here waiting for sales. Well, I tell you that quick story, Roshonda Pratt, to tell you that client after client that I meet, and no offense to them or anyone here, that just like my 12-year-old daughter who thinks that I created a Facebook page, I'm gonna be awesome, and I'm gonna start having customers, just creating the page or just creating the platform is not enough. You want to stand out. So are you staying relevant in the mind of your audience? Raise your hand if you have Facebook on your mobile device right now. Okay, so in addition to checking Facebook when you happen to maybe be at your desktop, in addition to being either a wife or a parent or a pastor or someone that loves your job or being overworked or sleep deprived, we all are busy. And so social media is something that's just adding an opportunity for you to get connected with the people who you want to actually see. But see, the thing is, we're all busy. We all are busy, but it's not all just about being busy. It's about actually being relevant. So I ask you, are you staying relevant in the mind of your audience? Now, up here on the screen, I just have some of the things that we all think of when we think of social media. So Twitter, Facebook, we've got Instagram, Pinterest, Snapchat, LinkedIn, live video, podcast. It goes on and on and on. Now, I'll tell you this, and it's not on the slide. I am not here to condone or tell you that you need to be on all of these. And in fact, if I were to tell you my number one recommendation I give to any client I work with is you need to say, where is the audience I want to reach that is on social media? Not what's my favorite, not what's like is a perfect fit for me, the business owner, for the pastor, for the church, for the nonprofit. Where are the people already that we know that they're busy, and they all probably have these 7 apps on their phone too, but we all know that there's one main platform that's like their go-to. That's where you need to go as your first priority. If you have a marketing team, that's fantastic. We can change the narrative. But if you are busy and you say, I've got 2 hours a week, maybe, to devote to my social media, I need you to pick one platform, maybe two, and go there with excellence and do it well. Stop trying to show up in 7 places and being average and mediocre, because I don't feel that that is the calling for any person that's actually here today in this room. So I'm gonna share with you 5 simple things. And like Roshonda, I love social media. Before social media was called social media, now I was born in 1975, so I'm gonna like, tell my age here, which I just did. But I was the girl in 5th grade that had like the video camcorder like on my shoulder that my parents had just bought, and I was like making videos as if like I was the host of QVC, and I was like selling purses and like baby powder, like just for fun. And I laughed because I can see myself and my daughter who's 12, and I'm like making fun of her, like she's in there like making all these like musically videos, and I'm like, what are you doing? And then I answer myself. I said, she's doing exactly what I was doing a while back with the technology that existed when I was her exact age. But today, these are the five smart ways that I want you all to lead today to stand out on social media. Number one, you need to give value first. You need to earn the right to sell. Now, this is just a quick audit you can do on yourself, but if the last 10 posts that you have done on whatever platform you have chosen to do is you saying how great you are, what your product is, what your sale is, and why people need to buy from you, you're doing social media wrong.
That's right.
Even if you may be amazing, you need to earn the right to sell to people. You need to give value. If I had never met Kimmy before, and our only interaction in life has been here today since 9:30, but if I walked into any networking event, I walked up to him and said, oh, he looks like he's got it together. I'm like, well, I've got it together. Great, perfect client. But I walked right up and I said, hey, good to see you, Kimmy. Guess what? I want to tell you that I am fantastic at social media. And today, just today, if you would let me help you, I can audit your social media. I can help you get a solid social media strategy. And I can even come alongside you and train you and your team. And I can help you. Regardless of whether he's like, well, she looks put together. Oh, everything she just said, I believe. Is that awkward?
Yeah, awkward.
I mean, that's awkward. But every day in your feed, in my feed, businesses, brands are doing that on social media, and it's not okay. So I'm telling you, you need to earn the value. Have a five ways to do something. Like, give your information away to give that ability, because social media, to exactly echoing what Rashonda said, is to take something that's great and to amplify that message. Now, I'm not necessarily saying that great means that you have like a six-figure business. Great may be that you have that great idea. You're solid. You're a man or woman of God. You have something that you want more people to know about. But you have to come to social, give the value first, and earn that right to sell.